Hello everyone, welcome back to your GRE preparation with Infinity Education. Today in our 17th class, we will learn about the normal distribution or bell curve. This is also a part of standard deviation. So now let's see how a bell curve looks like. So this is how a bell curve looks like, where they are splitting almost in six parts, where those are in the middlemost point, this is mu, and on the right hand side, mu plus sigma, mu plus 2 sigma, mu plus 3 sigma, and in the left side, it's mu minus sigma, mu minus 2 sigma, and mu minus 3 sigma, where mu is mean and sigma is the standard deviation. The two middlemost part consist of 34% and 34% respectively of all the datas, and the next two part is 14% and 14%, and the last or the extreme two parts consist of 2% and 2%. Now let's do with some of the example so that the concept of normal distribution or the bell curve will be much more clear to you. The amount of seeds dispensed from a machine at the ABC Corporation is normally distributed with a mean of 0.9 ounce and a standard distribution of 0.1 ounce. If the machine is used 500 times, approximately how many times will it be expected to dispense one or more ounces of seeds? So the amount of seed dispensed from machine at an ABC Emporium is normally distributed. So we can draw the bell curve with mu, mu, sigma, and everything, with a mean, where mean and standard deviation, with a mean of 0.9 ounces. So we can write 0.9 here, and a standard distribution of 0.1 ounces. So we can write 1.0, 1.1, 1.2, and on the left-hand side, 0.8, 0.7, and 0.6. Approximately how many times will it be expected to be dispensed one or more ounces of seed? So one or more ounces, so actually they are looking for this particular zone. So for one or more ounces, it is 14% plus 2%, that is 16%. So if the machine is used for 500 times, so 16% of 500 times should be 16 into 5, that is 80 is the answer to the question. I hope the question is clear to you. Now let's see with one more example. At Presidency College, the 400 students taking history received an average score of 76 on the final exam, and the score is normally distributed. The bottom 16% of the score will receive a failing grade, and 8 students received 96 or higher. So that means we can see this is a quantcom question. So we must write ABCD first. And also from the question we have learned, the scores are normally distributed. So we must draw the bell curve first. Now they are saying 400 students taking history received an average score of 76. So we must write the value for 76 for mean, because we know mu equals to the mean. The bottom 16% of the score will receive the failing grade. So that means the bottom 16% is this zone only. 8 students received 96 or higher. So I have to find out what is the percentage for the 8 students with respect to the total. So we can do it 8 by 400 into 100. Like we are converting the 8 students to the percentage with respect to the total. So now if we do the simplification, we are having 8 as 2%. So that means this is showing the this part, the most highest part. So that is given as 96. So we are having mu equals to 76 and mu plus 2 sigma equals to 96. So we can have the value for sigma equals to 10. Now, if you see the question in quantity A, they are saying score at or below which the student failed the course, that is mu minus sigma, So we know the value for mu is 76 and sigma is 10. So mu minus sigma should be 66. So quantity A, we are having 66, and quantity B, we have already, that is 56. So we are getting quantity A greater. So A is the answer to the question. Now let's do with one more example. In a class, the score are normally distributed with mean and standard deviation as 72 and 8 respectively. A score is called exceptional by the class teacher if that is more than 2.5 standard deviation above the mean. What is the lowest possible integral score that would be ranked as exceptional? So here it is mentioned the score are normally distributed. So we must draw the bell curve and all this information. Now it is given with a mean of 72 and standard deviation as 8. So we can write mu as 72 and sigma as 8. Now the next set of information is a score is called exceptional by the class teacher if that is more than 2.5 standard deviation above the mean. So I have to find out 2.5 standard deviation above the mean, that is mu plus 2.5 sigma, that is 72 plus 2.5 into 8. So we are having that as 72 plus 20 equals to 92. But we have to keep our eyes on the important information because they are saying a score is called exceptional by the class teacher if that is more than 2.5 standard deviation above the mean. So it have to be more than 92. So more than 92 is not the answer to the question. So the answer to the question is 93. So sometimes if in the question it is mentioned that the score are normally distributed, then also we may have not to use the bell curve. We can do the question without using the bell curve as well. Now, I hope the question is clear to you and the concept related to the bell curve is clear to you as well. Now, if you are having any doubt regarding any question or any point at understanding, or if you are practicing some question from other sources as well, and if you are having any doubt from there, you can always post that in the comment section. Thank you, everyone. Happy learning.